Today's introductory session, we are going to discuss about the status and all these things. Before that, this is Suresh. I have been working on data space with different versions and different modules of OS also from last 7 years. Could you please mute by your own, okay, all people who are not speaking? In today's session, what we are going to discuss means that is we will discuss about data stage and quality stage 8.7. In demo session, we are going to cover what are the actual topics we will cover in our total duration of 40 hours and what are the materials we are going to provide. Apart from data stage, what are other tools we are going to discuss? So those all things. In this session, I am going to present. For this data stage and quality stage version 8.7, before starting into data stage, few people are okay already working on different data warehousing, other tools maybe, but you are completely new to the data warehouse. For them, we need to know basic features about data warehouse. Those are nothing but a data warehousing fundamental. Means to create a data warehouse, what are the process we are going to follow? What is this data warehouse first of all? What is the purpose of this data warehousing in any business world? What is the meaning of operational data store? What is the basic difference between operational systems to this data warehousing system and data warehouse life cycle? These concepts we are going to discuss in fundamental. While we are giving it fundamental session, we will use the two PPTs to discuss that one. The same PPTs whatever we have here, we are also going to share these PPTs to you. You can also use these PPTs for your reference. Here we are going to discuss, okay, what is the purpose of data warehouse, what is the meaning of operation system, what kind of operation systems means, transactional systems are there in any. Okay, difference between those two warehouse systems. And after completion of this data warehousing basics, like up to data warehousing implementation approaches, and one more is also data warehouse architecture, then we'll go for next module, that is data modeling. Actually, this modeling is not going to do by data space developers who are working as a data space resource. You are not going to do any modeling, but that one, there is separate team will be there, data modeling team. They are going to create a model for our data. As a developer, we also need to have knowledge on this modeling, because once modeling process is completed by our data modeling team, they are going to share you some kind of document, modeling documents to us. We need to look into those modeling documents. We need to understand what are the process we are going to do in this modeling and how we are going to implement this model and how, what are the process we are going to have in this particular model, that we need to discuss in this modeling part. While we are discussing this modeling unit, I am going to cover you how to do modeling by modeling team also. Not very in depth, because if you want to work on this modeling again, we need to know data modeling tools also, like Irving data modeler or other products also. There are multiple products also there supporting by this data model. But as a developer, how much we need? We need, what is this, a dimension table? What is the meaning of fact table? What type of modeling we are going to implement? What is the meaning of normalization? How to implement this R schema, complex schema, these kind of schemas, we will discuss in this modeling part. Okay, once this data warehousing fundamental classes and modeling classes will take, I think, 5 sessions. Once these 5 sessions are completed, please mute yourself who is not speaking. I'm getting some disturbance a little bit. If you have any questions, you can unmute yourself and you can ask. Okay, see, once this modeling part done, then we'll go for ETL basics. Here ETL basics means, what is this ETL tool? ETL means extraction, transformation, loading. How to do this ETL process? What are the different type of ETL tools are available in market? What is the differentiation between this data space ETL tool to other ETL tools like Informatica, Ab initio, BODS, and with SSI, okay, integration services in MSBI? Means we are going to compare with other ETL tools and we are going to discuss about the basic ETL process, whatever we have in data stage. Up to this, we are going to completely discuss in basics part. Next, we are going for the actual data stage tool. Before we are going to actual ETL tool, you will get data stage software. Our admin will install DataSpace software into your machines also, either 8.5 or 8.7 version, depend upon your system configuration. We can install any version. Once installation is done, okay, in this particular DataSpace software, what are the components we are going to get? The major components you are going to receive in DataSpace are these. These are all our client components. Okay, we need to discuss how to work on these all client components. And what are the different source systems are there to get the data? In these client components also, the below two, what are the client components are available here, or belongs to administrative client components. We'll also discuss that one as well. If you want to apply for a data space developer position, then no need of knowledge on admin side. But at least minimum knowledge, okay, but not very in-depth knowledge. If you want to apply for a data space administrator side, means there are multiple openings you can see. When you upload the openings in DICE or Kartikorp or any other portal, you can see data stage administrator requirement, data stage developer requirement, and data stage developer with quality stage knowledge, data stage developer with information analyzer knowledge. There are multiple requirements we can see. When we see those requirements, depend upon our requirements, we can know and we are going to work on that particular client component. But we are going to discuss all major client components which are required for developer as well as administrators. Okay, these are our 10 client components will be there. One is designer client component, director client component, IBM information service, server console, information services manager, fast track, import export manager, multi-client manager, command line, and these two are admin. Sub console for IBM information server, and one more is admin. If you see the content of this one, we mentioned that all into different units. Here, data stage designer is simply kind of developer client component. When you go for the developer client component, in developer client component, we are going to discuss about, okay, what is this data stage development, how we are going to start with development, what is the different type of servers we are going to have when we are working as a developer, what is the different type of partition techniques and parallelisms we can apply in data stage. Okay, those things. And how to connect from data space to other applications like databases, some flat files, some mainframe systems, some XML data. Those things also we are going to discuss in designer environment. And to do some ETL operations, ETL means extraction, transformation, loading. If you want to do this loading operation and transformation operation, this transformation, especially if you want to do transformation, we have some processing space out there. Those processing stages, whatever we have, we'll also discuss those things. And some are advanced stages are there, which are added directly from version 8.1 of data stage. 8.1 or 8.1 to 8.5 and 8.5 to 8.7 also. You are going to receive, there are so many new stages are there, surrogate key implementation stages, range lookup process, slowly changing dimension table implementation, and FTP process, job performance analysis, resource estimation, performance optimizers, and transformer state loop conditions, transformer state last row handling conditions. These are all the things we want to discuss in advanced course of these things also. Apart from designer, we are also going to discuss other client components. Just let me show you how we are going to log into this data stage and what kind of components we are going to work. To log into so this data stage, once installation is done into your machine, simply double click on this client. But in our companies, when you are working, these data space software and data space complete client and server software they are going to install on remote machines. To access those remote machines, maybe they will give you Citrix access or VPN. So that one we are going to log in the remote machine. Okay, then we can open data state there. That's okay, here we are going to pass the host name and username and password. I'm passing this data state, login into this data state version 8.5 or 8.7 also will be there in different machine to me. I can also show you 8.7, what are the new features added in 8.7 also. Here in this project, okay, this is the data state project I'm logging. Just click on login. When you click on login, it will log into this data space designer window. In this designer window, we have different informations will be there. Most recently opened data quality means in data space, apart from normal ETL process, we can also implement quality process. That simply we can call as quality stages. I'll explain what is this quality stage also. Jobs. Okay, there are other options also there. In data state, there are multiple categories of versions of jobs is there. Most of them clients are going to use parallel, and if you come parallel here, and this I'm showing you how the jobs will be there, which are already I created for my previous batches. If I'm opening existing repository, inside this one we have jobs, inside this we have data stage. This I'm opening one simple job. If you see, this is a job which we designed graphically to my one of previous batches. It is taking data from some Oracle database. It's doing different transformation operations and loading data into again different Oracle tables. Okay. This kind of graphical designs we are going to design in data space designer client component. These we are going to call in data space with the name job. We are going to call it with the name job. Here, what is the meaning of job means? A job is nothing but an executable component which is used to do ETL operation, extraction, transformation, and loading operation. When we design this kind of jobs, this is one simple job. We may have other jobs also. See, this is other kind of job. Like this, we are going to discuss in class how to design this kind of jobs, even some complex jobs also, how to design this kind of jobs. How to put naming standards, how to get the rejected data, if any of the data you got rejecting. So these kind of links, how to establish, what is the performance we are going to design, performance tuning approaches for what we are going to follow. So these are all the things we are going to discuss in this session. Once we designed these all the things in our data stage with a designer, for example, if I design one data stage job, but my job got aborted while running or while loading data into warehouse, then what kind of performance tuning technique we need to follow? If job is aborted in the middle of process, what steps need to immediately taken? Those we are going to discuss in data space director client component. Apart from designer and director, we are also going to discuss about administrator. Generally, what activities this administrator client component we can do? As the administrator, admin is a person who is going to create a project, build a project, cleaning up the files, setting up the environment related things, adding up national language supporting parameters, creating users. For example, today I joined as a new employee in my organization. Then we are going to send my information to my admin. He is going to create one username and password to me. In case one employee leave from the organization, then he is going to remove his name first. Sorry. Like this kind of admin. Sorry. Like this kind of admin related activities also, how to perform? So I have a good experience on admin side as well. You want to apply for administrator position, you can also apply. But if you want to know more about administrator, first of all, you should know about database and Unix also, good knowledge. Because we are going to install this data space software on Unix machines or Linux machines. Then connectivity and creating of the temporary data structure, resource data structure, everything you should know as administrator. We are also going to discuss how to do these, all the things. And few sequences. The sequence means kind of batch job creation. For example, we are 10 people are working on a project. Each and every developer designed 5 by 10 jobs like that. Totally 200 jobs are designed. I want to run these 200 jobs as a batch. If you want to run 200 jobs as a batch, whatever we designed, we have a specially designed environment that is called sequence. Means in data set itself, when you go for these jobs, what jobs we are creating like this, we are going to put these, all the jobs in sequence. Just I am opening one sequence which I created for my previous batch. Like this, we are going to put all our jobs in sequences. Okay, this kind of sequences we are going to, even not only this kind, some complex sequence also, we are going to create. This is a batch. In this batch, we are having, there are multiple jobs here. These are all our jobs, whatever we design in data space. If you want to see any job which is there inside that one, you can simply select, right click here, open job. Inside that job, it may be simple job or complex job, anything. But whatever jobs you design, those jobs you can see and you can open and request. Okay, there are multiple jobs in there. Open and see the accounts of those things and every parameter and everything also. How to design these kind of the batches also we need to know, because once development is completed, as a developer, you need to create this kind of batches. Once your testing is completed, you are going to send your batches to testing team. Those testing team who are working as in testers, simply they are going to use those testing, whatever you send as a batches, they will run those batches in their environment while processing data from source to warehouse. In testing case, if they identified any defects or any issues, they will raise a ticket on development team. Okay, they will raise, because they don't have much knowledge on ETL tool, that is maybe data science, any other tool also. They have knowledge on QC, they have knowledge on other tools also, but they will simply run the batch. If batch successfully finish, then they will start doing testing. If any failure in the batch, they will simply raise a defect on development team. Okay, we need to check what kind of batches we created. In case my batch is running, but I want to send a mail notification to my downstream saying that today your file will be late. How to send a notification? Those notification, everything we can set up in this batch. We will discuss how to set up this batch and how to run batch also. Next thing is information analysis. What is the different type of information we are having? Those information analysis also we can do, like data profiling, column analysis, primary key analysis, and foreign key analysis. This is also one of the new features added from version 8 onwards. This also we can discuss. And information server admin, because if you see in data stage, there are two administrator client components are present. What are those mean? One is desktop administrator, and second one is web console for IBM information server, that is simply we can call as web-based administrator. This web-based administrator and desktop administrator, whatever we are working, desktop administrator is generally used to control the server, control the developers. But what is the web-based administrator client component we are having here? By using this web-based administrator client component, we will be able to, just I'm logging into this one. By using this client component, we will be able to create a new user who are joining as a new developer, and we will be able to create a report. We will be able to do kind of business grocery analysis, and we will be able to define domain management, log management, session management, the all activities we can do. See, right now, this screen is going to show us a welcome screen. Welcome screen for information server. Now, when we go for this administrator client component, here we have different domains are there, like domain management, session management, and users and groups creation. For example, a new employee joined today, then we want to create a new user. I'll show you how to create a new user. If you want to create a new user, go for new user option. There you can specify your username, password, confirm password, first name, last name, other details which are not mandatory also. If you want to specify name, phone number, email ID, fax number, those things. And for that user, whoever we created, we need allocate role also. Is he an administrator, or is he a developer, or a qualitative developer? There are multiple roles you can see here. These roles you can allocate. Okay, business glossary administrator, business glossary author, business glossary basic user, business glossary user, data science qualitative admin. If you want to allocate that user as admin, you can put this one. If you want to put that one as a developer, simply put data science qualitative user. And other things also, information analyzer, information sensor, fast track, metadata workbench. And if you want to write some quality stage rules also, there are some quality stage rules that admin is there, rules author is there, rules manager is there, and role user is there. There are multiple roles is there. Which roles you want to apply for the developer, you can also apply. In the same way, you can also create some group. Apart from normal individual user ID, we can also create one group ID. How to create the group ID also? We can discuss as administrator and log management. Once you compile your any of your ETL components, if you are running some kind of log, it will display in data state director. So this is called log. In log, what type of message you want to display? Here type means control message, info message, warning message. Okay, these kind of what type of message you want to display? Those message components. And if you want to create your own log also, means custom logs, you can also create those logs in log management. And we can also do some kind of scheduling also. How to do the scheduling, we can discuss. And some reporting layers, how to generate reports, and okay, glossary, business glossary, terminology. Those are all things we are going to discuss in this administrator client component. These all will come under this administrator. Apart from that, we also need to discuss about quality stage. If you see most of requirements right now in DICE or Car2Car or in any other specific region in central states, there you will be able to find requirement with the data stage with quality stage, data stage with information analyzer. Who are having knowledge on quality stage or work experience on quality stage, most of clients are interested. Even if you go for Citibank, Bank of America, Wells Fargo, UNC, and major clients, okay, any of the other clients which are there, they are going to use this quality stage to provide the qualitative data in output. Up to data stage version 8, this quality stage is separate software. At the time, we need to purchase the separate software and we need to install. But from version 8 onwards, this quality stage also included in data stage. Okay, this simply we are going to have this including of this into data stage here. Those whatever we are having, how to work on quality stage developer. What is this quality stage? What kind of issues we have? How to design jobs with this quality stage? What are the major processes we are going to do in quality? That is investigation operation, standardizing operation, and matching operation, surviving operation, and MNS and waves. What is MNS and waves mean? MNS means multinational standardization stage, and waves means worldwide address verification and enhancement system. Okay, just let me show you how we are going to create this quality stage jobs in data stage. To work on quality stage, when you see our palette, let me go for palette. We have separate categories of stages are available for quality. Check the quality of our data. What are those stages mean? Investigation stage, match frequency, MNS, quality stage legacy, reference match, SQA, standardization stage, survive, unduplicate match, waves. All we have under this quality. We are going to work as a quality stage developer, and this we can do different type of quality operations with our process. Here, when you go for this quality stage, we have how to design jobs and what kind of jobs we are going to identify. Just let me show you. In my previous batch, I also designed some quality stage jobs. Just I'm going to apply some quality stage rule sets here. See, this is the quality stage stages. Rest of stages, whatever we have here, normal ETL stages only. When we go for this piece, shows quality safe part. Yes, I'm opening just to show you. Here we are applying multiple country rules. Here I'm applying US names, US address, US area rules. Means I want to check who are the customers' data is coming from US, whether their names are correct format, whether their address is correct or not, whether their area names, whatever they mention in a application, those are correct or not, I want to check. Even apart from these domain rules, I want to check email ID also, whether their email ID is correct or not, whether their phone number, whatever they mention is correct phone number or not, okay, with the proper extension is there or not. These kind of data quality issues, if you want to check and if you want to identify, if you want to correct those quality issues, we have these kind of quality state stages. Foundation stage, MN stage, view stage. There are multiple other stages also you can see to occur quality stage. Just okay, let me show you how to do this quality operation is like this. Even investigation. We can do investigation of data and even we can do MNS. MNS means multinational standardization. When we go for this MNS stage, we can apply multiple country rule sets to check the address. Especially this MNS means multinational standardization of address data. I want to check address data, city data, state data, zip code and country code. Like this, we are going to pass our data. By using that data, we can also load into warehouse. Okay. Now, whatever the data we are identifying in this one, once you run the job, we are going to get some quality results. Check that when the entire data, whatever we have, are this data is good data, are this data is having for country name, proper state name, such a kind of data you can see now. And just you click on OK. Once you pass your data, because you have some huge amount of data, that's why this is taking this much time to open. File. See, this is the data we have, we send into customer data, full name, address line 1, address line 2, city name, state name, zip code, postcode, like this. Once it checks that all city names are matched, in city name they did not mention any neighborhood, state name is also, state abbreviation is matched, and postal code is matched, and 2 byte ISO country code, this data belongs to US. Like this, we can check for different countries. In single job itself, just I'm checking, showing here US. There are other countries that also maybe there in below. Here Italy, okay, Canada, France, Japan, Germany. There are multiple other countries that are Great Britain. Other countries that also we can check in quality state, we can get the good result of qualitative data into output. So how to design this quality state job? What kind of quality state we are going to have? Those things we are going to discuss up to this 10 hours of the session. Next, once quality stage and normal data stage and ETL basic concepts are completed, we'll go for one project. One project we'll take. In that project, we'll discuss about the architecture of the particular project and what are the business requirement documents we receive on this particular project. What is the major subject areas involved in the particular project? What type of dimension tables and fact tables there? Flow of each and every subject area. How to design this high level design document and low level design document of project. Especially, if you are applying for a position of developer, then you need to know at least low level design, not for high level design. At least you should also aware of how to design this low level document and how to design jobs, data state jobs, what kind of complex jobs we are going to discuss, and how to do unit testing of your data state process. Means once your data state code is designed, if your job is successfully compiled, you are going to create some kind of unit testing test cases. How to write these test cases? What kind of test cases we are going to write as a developer? That unit testing process also how to do, we'll discuss. Apart from unit testing, we also have different testing is there. Those are system testing, user acceptance testing, regression testing, and end-to-end testing. Apart from normal development testing, right, what ETL testers will do? As an ETL tester, they are going to involve in different phases of testing like system testing, user acceptance testing, regression testing, and end-to-end testing, how to do all the testing phases and where we are going to involve. As a developer, where we are going to involve in those phases? As a developer, we are not going to involve any of these phases. If our ETL testers identify any of the defects, then we are going to resolve those issues. And once we develop the code, how to deploy from one environment to other environment? Deployment to different phases of our project. How to do that one? And creation of the job design document, ORA document, tech specs, low level design document. And once our code is ready, it will go for production, generally in any project. When our code is in production, what kind of issues we are expecting? What are the major support our organizations are going to expect when you go for production support? What are the levels of support will be there? What type of incidents you are going to receive? What are the major issues you received in production support when you are working on any particular project? And apart from this normal ETL process, we also need to know some automation process. How to do some automation by using any scripting. What kind of automation scripts we have? And how to do this scheduling of our data with other tools like ControlMN AutoSys, and any problem tickets or incidents or any defects, whatever you receive, how to fix. Also, we are going to discuss shooting. These are all the things we are going to discuss at least few hours in a project. Then, coming to the materials wise, you are going to receive lot of materials. Once you conform to class, you are going to receive data warehousing fundamentals materials, database materials, data science materials, performance tuning materials, certification guides who want to apply for data science version 8.5, because up to now we have only 8.5 certification only in data science. If you want to do certification also, I have some of the materials and dumps is there. You can use those to write certification to complete it also. Even in quality science certification also, if you want to do, you can do it. And data science materials, some project, what the project you are going to discuss in class, those project materials also you will receive. So these are all things also you will receive in materials like Unix materials, data science materials, database materials, project materials, Unix scripting. Okay, these are all the materials you are going to receive. Plenty of materials. There is no only one help guide or something. There are a lot of materials you will receive. Nearly 800 to 900 MB of the size will be there of those materials. That much, okay, and project related materials also you will receive lots about the project to understand the flow of your project, which you are working and process on your implementation. These are all the things we are going to discuss in up to 40 hours of session. This is about the tool what we are going to discuss in actual sessions. Any questions? Anyone having any questions or anything?
Suresh?
Yeah.
Is the software free download or how can we get the software to get installed on our local laptop?
It's not a free download or something. We will share you some links to you.
Okay.
Okay, that you can download off of that link.
And once you install, after some time, will that expire or something like that? Or we can continue practice even after class is over? Can we?
That actually, we are going to pay some amount to admin actually. That we need to check with admin. I think, okay, he's taking care most of the time. In case any issues is there or something, he's okay, helping to resolve that issue. In case, okay, it's not working, he's doing his reinstallation. That's not a problem, I think. That's not a big issue.
Okay. Is 8.7 is the latest version, or is there more latest than this?
8.7 is the latest version, but IBM is planning to release 9.1, but it's not at release.
Okay.
8.1 now, up to now 8.7 is the latest version.
So quality stage is a totally independent tool than the data stage, is that?
Earlier it is independent, but right now completely integrated. Data stage and quality stage integrated with the single palette only. But up to 7 point version, like before 8 version, quality stage is separate tools. We are going to call that is essential quality stage version 7.5 like that. But from version 8 onwards, they completely integrated this quality stage and data stage now. But still, if you see the requirements, they are going to ask specially quality stage.
Correct.
Because few people don't have quality stage knowledge. Who are working on data stage, they don't have quality stage knowledge. They don't know how to use this quality stage and everything. So the reason, if you observe the requirement, even quality stage, even information analyzer also right now, it's a part of data stage only. But when you come into requirement, it's completely a different requirement. Information analysis, and quality stage, developer, admin, there are multiple requirements within.
So you mentioned there are 10 tools installed once we install data stage, correct? 10 applications
right.
Right,
10 client components, yeah.
So once the course is over, we will get thorough with all those, understand exactly each tool is doing what?
Right, but okay, not required of all those tools, because a few are belongs to very high level. We need a majorly, that's what depend upon your, you want to apply for position. For example, you want to apply for developer and quality stage and information analyzer, then we need these two and this one.
Okay.
And these are used to do a kind of deployment. Only for deployment
okay.
process we have. These are simple then, not much,
okay.
but very important are very biggest two, these are. The very biggest
okay.
clients are these two and these two.
Okay.
And we also
okay.
going to discuss about this also. The major client component which we are going to focus is developer, you
okay.
have to apply for a position of developer, quality stage developer, information analyzer and admin. Those four roles generally you can see. These are normal one. Everyone whoever want to work as a developer, they will use it.
Okay, okay.
Suresh?
Yes, ma'am.
How will be the sessions like how will be the examples which we develop during this training, like is this some kind of a, I mean real time scenarios you will be discussing in the class or
right completely real time, because even that's what when we are working on a project, especially we are going to use the project related documents also. There are
mm-hmm.
multiple batches at all. Okay, only this batch is for course batch.
Mm-hmm.
Only project also we are going to discuss 40 hours. Only data stage project 40 hours also. Like this depends, and only information analyzer and quality stage also 40 hours is there. But this is a session which we are discussing overall. Few people
yeah.
are already working on data stage, for example, they are already working on data stage, they need advanced topics. They need only what are the recently added in 8.5, 8.7, and what is the quality stage, what is the information analyzer. That is completely different session that is having a 40 hours of time. And only few people already learned the data stage tool from other or something, they need projects. We have that type of sessions also. We are planning to start that for project session, completely 40 hours project. And this is a course batch. In this course batch, we are going to cover core along with that some project information and little bit of a quality stage on information analyzer function. But very in-depth means it will take too much time. Frankly speaking, this 40 hours is not enough to discuss very in-depth of knowledge. But what are the examples I am giving? Completely I am going to use project only, project documents only. Just let me open. Every day when I am discussing, I am going to use some specification documents and some live examples, or not okay, critical or something. Everything apart from basic concepts of data warehouse, once we are into tool, we'll completely follow the real-time scenarios, how to implement and how to process the data into warehouse, what kind of complex situations we are going to face, and what kind of jobs we are going to implement, and what type of data we are going to receive, what type of okay, scripts we are going to write. We'll completely follow a particular project.
You mentioned like in sequences and all like so are you gonna provide some real time scripts like the cron tab scheduling like a unique setup and all like because so if you want to apply a job you know so you know
right.
Right so the questions can come out from anywhere like it might not only in the data set perspective but it may also like some little bit like bad job creation unique setup
right right
like
right when you go for that's what I'm telling when you go for any interview on ETL they will not ask much questions on data set frankly speaking they are going to ask questions on database side Unix side
mm-hmm.
and scheduling tool they'll ask on tickets how to handle the defects of tickets and modeling pods and they'll also ask on data set for example if they ask 30 questions in those 30 questions 5 are on database 5 are on Unix 10 questions on data set 5 questions on modeling and 5 questions on server scheduling tools also that's what in project we are going to cover scripting I'm not going to discuss basic Unix command you need to learn by your own
Yeah,
if you want,
that's understand.
Yeah. Different. Okay, I'm going to discuss some scripting also. When you go for project, what kind of script we are going to use? Those
mm-hmm.
scripts. Just okay, let me open one script. This is one script here. This script is used to run data set job in Unix. From command line, I want run data set job. We write a one script. That script name is dsjoblaunch.sh. This is the kernel shell script. How to write that kernel shell? Okay, script. How to run this kind of scripts also? I like that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah.
Okay, these scripts whatever we have, I'll also share you these scripts to you guys. You can also go to that one material. If you have any questions, you can also ask.
Yeah, that's excellent.
Sorry.
So when you are, sorry.
Yeah, go ahead.
Only question is when we are installing on our laptop, we don't have any Unix on our laptop, Unix or Linux. So,
if you want, you can also install Unix, but these admins who are installing this data space version is not Unix version of data space, it's a Windows version of data space only. But you can install the Unix separately, there is no issue.
Yeah.
Either Unix or Linux, you can install. Just to practice purpose, okay, you can install. But data set server we are not going to install on Unix because the version they are going to provide is not a Unix version. They are going to provide Windows versions only. But we can install even in Google also you can find free Unix software you can download. Otherwise, while installing data set by admin, you can ask admin, okay, he is going to install Unix in your machine.
Right.
So
that,
I have a question like this. So, when we are discussing about the data set, it's mostly like all the stages, right? So, how many stages we are going to discuss, like all the complete, the palette or any specific important, like I see like there are some column export and column import stages also.
Right, those are also useful in projects, right, right. That's called restructure stages. Those restructure stages also we are going to discuss. See,
how
most of the stages which, just let me tell you. What are the major stages we are going to see in discuss in parallel mean? We are going to discuss all the important stages in quality stage. And databases wise, we are going to discuss a few databases because I don't have all the databases like Informix and Netija. Those databases I don't have to install in my machine. Even those are also not supporting for latest versions of data stage, which admin is trying to install. We can discuss Teradata, SQL, Oracle, and StorePresser. See, databases, when it comes to databases wise, all databases options is same, only query writing is different. If you go for Teradata, options will be same. If you go for Oracle, options will be same in data space size. But actually when you are writing query in databases, completely will be different. Some syntax will be different, everything will be different. I know Teradata, I worked on, I have good experience on Teradata, DB2, Oracle, D3 databases. I don't have other database knowledge, but actually, if even I want to get, I can get the knowledge, but I don't have those databases, especially Informix, Iway. Those are not okay. Free databases, we need to get it, but I don't have the database. If those installed in our machine, we can discuss. But I don't tell you one thing. If you know one database, it's enough to work on all databases. Only connection details will change. Rest of all are common only. And this debug and development, we will discuss all stages. File, we will discuss all whatever we required, okay, complex log file, file set, data set, okay, sequential file, whatever we required, we can discuss. Processing almost all stages, because we need majorly processing stages. In processing stage, we can discuss aggregator, change, capture, change, apply, these are all stages. The main important is surrogate key stage, slowly changing, transformer stage. If you go for other faculties, generally we are going to discuss the transformer stage within half an hour. But I will discuss it in 1 week. Nearly six sessions, 6 hours of session, we are going to discuss only about this transformer.
When you say transformer, we will discuss the looping and the gets, all those functions?
Everything, okay. Every function. That's what transformer stage itself will take nearly 1 week of time. Only transformer will take 1 week. That's
okay,
what I'm telling. If you go for other trainers, generally what they are going to do is they will discuss only basic, okay, what the function and everything. But when it comes to data stage and I'm discussing, okay, at me, I'll discuss how to do this, okay, transformer looping example, okay, how to write the loops in transformer stage.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I write a simple loop, iteration of loop. How to write this kind of loop? Right. How to, okay, see the these kind of loops and how to write some complex functions in transformer also. Just when you go for this transformer stage,
mm-hmm.
you can write some, okay, stage variables, how to write the stage variables, okay. There are multiple things. We can discuss everything which is required to work on because in data stage, frankly speaking, the most important and very useful stage is transformer. If you know transformer, half part of data stage is finished. Because most of transformation logics you are going to do in transformer. Rest of stage are very simple in parallel.
And also like I see there is a difference, right, in the server job and the parallel job. The transformer is the, one is the basic one and another is the C++ code, I think, right?
Right. What the server job transformer is there, that transformer we simply going to call as a basic transformer. There we are going to use the basic language. But the transformer stage which we are having in parallel job, that is completely PX transformer, parallel extender transformer. That parallel extender transformer, whatever we have, that transformer, we are going to have C++ coding in background. That's what when we are installing data stage also, we need to install a framework, parallel framework in background, that is maybe .NET framework or Visual C++ framework or C++ compiler, then only this parallel transformer will work.
If you can give me one, like how to write a function and how to compile, just a demo or sample example, that will be great. Like, I mean, because you know, like we have to write a couple of functions, like especially when we are dealing with files, to remove, you know, faces, special characters, blah, blah, things like that.
Anything, so, anything, right.
So if you can give just a demo, I'm not expecting like to write a C++ some hard coding, but just a simple function, you know, so that by looking
See, C++ hard coding you will not be able to write. One thing you need to remember here, if you want to create your own stage, that is called build up stage.
No, not I'm asking about the stage, I'm asking about a simple function where we can invoke that function in transformer.
Right, that's what I'm telling, just a second. Let me open one.
Because in a couple of interviews, you know, they're asking this kind of question, like, have you written any function, and how? If you write, how do you process, how do you know, compile and link, things like that.
Right, I know that. See, when it comes to this, okay, transformer stages, okay, I think it will take too much time because I have another session, I need to jump in the class. Let me take, in our class, generally, we are going to take, okay, a lot of complex examples of transformer also.
Mm-hmm.
And we will write, that's what I'm telling, 1 week of time, I'm going to completely sit on transformer stage only. Otherwise, no need of 1 week. Within 10 minutes, we can complete now without discussing transformer stage function. We can complete half an hour. Within a half an hour, we are going to complete transformer. But we need, okay, that transformer very in-depth means you should always know transformer very in-depth knowledge. Yep, right, let me show you. Maybe another link, we have other jobs. See, this is one simple example for transformer. In this example, what we are doing is we are writing three stage variables here. These are called stage variables. One is new ID, comparison, old ID, three stage variables. And what we are doing in this one is, we are simply capturing unique records into one side, duplicate records in one side. In my input file, when we see the data, we have a lot of duplicate records. Yes, I'm trying to show you. The path is mistake, so just a second. Let me change the path. Input file. This file path is changed. Just let me change the path of my. Of all of them, only path of file is I call I move files into different directory. See, this is the data I am getting. In this data, if you observe, there are one customer ID, one record, three is there, means with a duplicate. Now, I want to get unique records into one side and duplicate records in one side. In transformer stage, we can do that one. If you use the remove duplicate stage, one stage is there. But in remove duplicate stage, when you use in data stage, it will get only unique records. There is no chance to capture duplicate records. Because that stage will not support multiple output links. But when it comes to this transformer stage, we can support n number of output links. When you are using n number of output links, one link you are going to get unique records, one link you are going to get duplicate records. How to get it? Before applying any functions in this transformer, first you need to sort your data. In link level, how to do that? If you want to,
you can use sort, right? So that you can use the sort and you can apply the key chain is equal to 1 and 0. You can do that, right?
Right. How many ways you know?
Sorry?
How many ways you know?
Yeah, that is one way. Transformer the other way, and that's what.
Okay, for any operation, there are multiple ways. You can do by using sort stage, you can do by using transformer stage.
No, I'm just giving an example.
See, that's what I'm telling. Okay, by using aggregator stage also, you can do first count, calculate the count of record. If count is greater than 1, that you can consider as a duplicate record.
Okay,
there are multiple ways, and even by using transformer itself, not by using this condition, we can simply write a stage variable. In the stage variable itself, we can do some simple kind of looping operation. If same record is repeating n number of times, we can consider that one as a duplicate. If it is not repeating n number of times, we can consider that one as a duplicate. There are multiple ways. Okay,
yeah,
not
sure.
Only one way. Just okay, in transformer, as you ask, okay, that's what I am showing you here. There are ways, even when we go for class, I will show you all the ways, not only transformer ways, how to do with that remove duplicate, how by using cluster key in sort stage. How to do by using aggregator stage, how to do by using transformers, because when you go for interview, they will not ask you only transformer. Simply they are going to ask the question, how can you remove the duplicate by using other stage apart from transformers. When they ask that question, you tell sort stage or aggregator stage, any other stage. We can use, okay, even in link level sorting also we can do, no need to go for any stage also. Link level, in a particular link also you can specify the unique property there, in a link sort, there also you can get starting of the data, and there also you can get unique records. This is a simple example I am giving here. In this one, we are writing three stage variables. First, I am giving customer ID mapping, and third stage variable also I am giving customer ID mapping. But in below stage variable, second stage variable, we simply write one if-then-else condition for the functions is there in transformer stage. When we go for these functions in transformer stage, we will discuss all these functions. No need to worry about it. Okay. If I am not able to discuss, I will return your entire class amount to you. No need to worry, that's what. Half an hour class, I am not going to discuss on transformer. If you go for other trainer, they will take only half an hour. Within half an hour, they will not cover at least two functions also. At least 5 to 6 hours, we need to sit on transformer to discuss entire all the functions. At least major functions, which are we are going to use every day. Date function, last row handling function, logical function, null handling function, even number also few functions we are going to use, string category, all functions we need to discuss, and type conversion, we want to do one data type to other data type conversion. Then we'll go for this type conversion of the transformers. Here what I am doing is, if new ID is equal to old ID I am writing, first time when I give a mapping, customer ID for example 100 ID come into this. But when I write new ID is equal to old ID means, now old ID is blank, nothing is there, it's a empty, because we allocate a old ID next stage variable. always while executing a transformer say stage variable, first this stage variable will execute, next this stage variable will execute, next this will execute. While executing second stage variable, if new ID having a value of 100, but old ID don't have any value, then what is going to happen? If this is not equal, then it will go to move the data into link 2. There are two links there in output. In constant of that output link, we write comparison is equal to 1, comparison is equal to 2. 2 means second link it will come. In the DS link 8, you are going to receive all unique records. In comparison 1, you are going to receive all duplicate records. First, at the time of checking this one, it should try to identify unique records. Next, we have customer ID allocated to old ID. Now again 100 is allocated to old ID. Once it processes first record, then go for second. Automatic loop will be there. If you want to write manually loop, again you can use loop condition. But in this case, there is no need to write any loop. An automatic, for you have 100 records. One it will compare. Two it will compare. Like this, it will compare one by one record. Finally, when you run this job, you are going to receive unique records into one side and duplicate records into one side. Just let me show you. Right. After running of this job, we can see the data. Just run in. See, in total 86 records, 44 records come this side, okay, and the 44 records come in this side. You can see data. One side you have duplicate, one side you have unique records. This side you have duplicate records because three records are one. Two records came this side and unique records came into next link. You can view the data. Okay. That's not only one. All unique records we receive into this link, duplicate we receive into other link. Like this, there are so many operations we can do in transformer. Not only this one, even some complex operations also. We are going to write 30 to 40 stage variables in single job itself to do some complex operations. We will also discuss how to write complex stage variables and complex expressions in multiple if then else conditions, multiple functions in same. We are going to discuss everything whatever we have in transformer. Any questions?
So you said that, I mean, what are the other batches? Are you connecting any advanced batches also? That's what you mentioned in your...
Right. There are multiple batches are there. One is only for project. 40 hour session. One is for only advanced version like quality stage information library, advanced stage of data stage. That's also 40 hour session is there, and this is for only data stage with a little bit about quality stage and project.
Okay.
There are three batches I'm going to run.
Okay.
Okay, fine then. Already 10 minutes
late. Hi, Suresh.
Yep, you can.